Well, good morning. I'm reading from the book of Acts this morning. Paul and Barnabas on their first missionary journey. They launched out from Antioch and they made their way into the Galatian region. And as Paul and Barnabas come into another town called Antioch, this one in Pisidia, they go into the synagogue on the Sabbath day. Now, this was Paul's modus operandi. He would go into a place, look for a synagogue of the Jews. If he found one, then he would put on his full Pharisee regalia and go in and take part in the service. And at a certain point in the service, they had read from the law, they had read from the prophets, and then they said, hey, we've got some brothers here that are visiting us. We can tell they're Jews. We can tell that Paul is a Pharisee. Do you have anything to say? And Paul stood up and he began to preach Jesus to them. He began to explain to them that God had promised the Messiah and that Jesus was the promise. And unfortunately, that the Jewish leaders in Jerusalem had rejected him and condemned him. But in so doing, they had actually fulfilled what God was going to do with Jesus. And in verse 38 of Acts 13, Paul says, "Be it known unto you therefore, men and brethren, that through this man is preached unto you the forgiveness of sins." That's so absolutely important. The reason that Jesus came was to seek and save that which was lost. And he came to give his life a ransom. We have sin. And that sin separates us from God. And all of us do. And so he came to, through this man, he says, is preached unto you the forgiveness of sins. It goes on in verse 39 and says, "By him all that believe are justified from all things from which he could not be justified by the law of Moses." Now that would be a shocker for the Jew, because the law of Moses is absolutely essential to their teaching, to their preaching, to his faith. And so when he says, hey, only through Jesus can you be justified from these things that the law of Moses can't justify you from. Now, what does that mean? Well, it means very simply this. The law cannot save you. It never has been able to. As a matter of fact, it was never designed for that. Paul, in his letter to the Romans, chapter 3 and verse 19, says this. "Now we know that all things whatsoever the law saith, it saith to them who are under the law, that every mouth may be stopped, and all the world may become guilty before God." This is the point of the law. It stops the mouth. In other words, we're sitting here and we're arguing with God about whether or not we're a sinner. He says, "Look at my law." We look at his law and we see that it says, "Honor mother and father." It says, "Thou shalt not commit adultery." It says, "Thou shalt not kill." "Thou shalt not steal." It says, "Never blaspheme God." It says, "Thou shalt not covet." It says all of these things, and we look at our life, we look at ourselves, and we say, unfortunately, I've broken some of those things on that law. Therefore, I am guilty, and my argument with God stops. And verse 20 of Romans 3 says, "Therefore, by the deeds of the law, there shall no flesh be justified in his sight. For by the law is the knowledge of sin." And here we see the purpose of God's law. The purpose of God's law is to show us that we have sin in our lives, to prove to us that we are sinners. The purpose of Jesus is to come and take away our sin. He's the only one who can. That's why Paul says, "And by him all that believe are justified from all things from which he could not be justified by the law of Moses." Folks, that's the good news this morning, that you can be justified from all things that God's law holds us guilty of. And we have that justification only in Jesus Christ. How does that work? Well, he died on the cross to pay for those sins. That's how it works. It's called redemption. He is the propitiation, the satisfaction before Almighty God that sin has been paid for. See, my problem is I can't pay for my own sin. Well, I can. It takes eternity in hell to pay for my own sin. But since Jesus has no sin, he can pay for the sins of all of us. If we'll just trust him, that'll be reckoned to our account. Now that's good news. I hope you know him today. Have a great day.